Hey guys, Skyron here. Before we begin this video, I'd just like to ask that if you're enjoying these lore videos, it would mean so much if you could take 2 seconds to hit that subscribe button if you haven't already. It helps so much with the growth of the channel. Also, share this with one of your friends. Now, on with the video. The lore behind Jack of Blades. In Albion's long history, there have been many who have sought to take over and control the land, to bend this world to their will and enslave its citizens. One almost succeeded. And who was this, you ask? Jack of Blades. Back before the Age of Heroes and before the Old Kingdom, Albion was under the control of the evil beings of the court from a realm called the Void. Within this realm, Jack of Blades, Queen of Blades, and the Knight of Blades controlled the citizens of Albion through fear and threat using magical means. Although humans had existed for hundreds of years, the court had already existed for many more, enslaving the lesser mortal creatures with their power. The members of the court all had a mask, their masks capable of holding their souls, essentially allowing them to be eternal beings. Only seen possessing other creatures, no one had seen their true demonic forms. Well, not anyone that lived to talk about it. Unfortunately for the court, within the human population, a young man by the name of William Black appeared to possess magical abilities, and he made it his mission to destroy the court and free Albion from their rule. Seeing an opportunity, Jack planned to summon William to his realm and enslave him with an ancient and powerful weapon, the Sword of Aeons. One night, William studied an ancient tome to learn about the court. Here, Jack summoned him to the Void. Although Jack attempted to use the sword to enslave him, William's power was far too great and he escaped, taking Jack's sword with him. With the sword and its power, William managed to defeat the Knight of Blades in combat, killing it. Next, Jack attacked. In an epic battle, William managed to shatter Jack's body, although Jack's soul escaped. Next, William fought with the Queen of Blades and killed her after weeks of battle. With all 3 members of the court thought dead, Albion was released from them, and humanity thrived. With this, a kingdom grew. The mask of Jack appeared on the faces of dozens of heroes throughout the years, all claiming to be Jack while wearing it. Many believe that the mask acted as a vessel to hold the soul of Jack, and so, whoever came across it and was lured in by its promise of power became possessed by him. As the heroes wore the mask with a crimson hood and gauntlets to conceal any part of their physical appearance, no one could confirm that he was the same person all along. The only feature visible being his demonic glowing eyes, which shone through the eye holes. Along his waist, 2 other masks. Some believe these to be the masks of the Queen and Knight of Blades after their souls had been destroyed by William years before. With his ability to jump between bodies, Jack was able to take advantage of the heroic abilities these possessed, where he was shown to be a master of all 3 hero disciplines, strength, skill, and will. Stories of his nightmarish actions became tales that were told across Albion, one of these being the creation of the Screamer, will users tormented for eternity after they dared to go against him. these poor souls cursed to feel constant pain unless draining the life essence from the living. Over hundreds of years and many eras, from the destruction of the Old Kingdom to the rebuilding of a new Albion, his terrifying stories still filled the world where even the Guild of Heroes feared his potential return. Within the snowy region of Hook Coast, Jack came across a small boy and his family being attacked by Balverines. Although unable to save the parents, Jack saved the boy, and from that moment, Maze worked for him and committed awful deeds under his command. Jack also met with a young Elvira Grey and convinced her to murder her sister. In return, Elvira would become the new mayor of Bowerstone. It is also said that Jack was vital in the Battle of Bloody Harvest, although the details of this battle are still shrouded in mystery. Although most of his deeds evil, Jack still, by some, was celebrated as a hero. With his ability to manipulate important members of Albion, Jack had power and access to regions across the country. With this, he had power over Bargate Prison and seedy individuals around the towns. Although powerful, Jack's true aim was to recover the sword that had been stolen from him years ago. With the sword, he could control Albion. Discovering that his sword was locked away behind a ritual created by William Black, Jack sought out a hero that belonged to William's direct bloodline. Then, he discovered a family in the small farming village of Oakvale. In this town, one night, Jack ordered a bandit attack led by Maze to seek out the family. Discovering the house that they lived in, Jack attacked. He had the mother, Scarlet Robe, imprisoned within Bargate Prison. He stabbed her husband, Brom, and left him to bleed out. He turned to their daughter, Teresa, and cut out her eyes while she fled into the forest. And finally, they looked for her brother, who was nowhere to be seen. With a hero linked to William Black in his custody, he tortured Scarlet to find out how to unlock the secrets of the ritual to get back his sword that had been stolen centuries before. But for years, Scarlet resisted and refused to tell him anything. With his power and his seedy influence growing within Albion, Jack attempted to enter a demon door in a region now known as Fairfax Gardens. Although mighty and powerful, the door refused him entry. The boy that had evaded the attack that night in Oakvale grew, and with being a part of the ancient bloodline, he became extremely powerful. Through the years, he graduated from the Heroes Guild and performed quests across Albion, earning him fame and renown. With his renown, he was given the opportunity to fight in the Witchwood Arena. As the hero fought the arena's rounds, Jack viewed from above with a plan in mind. Successfully completing the arena, the young hero stared at a statue of his mother, who had been an arena champion. Here, Jack hands him the champion seal for completing the arena. Unknown to the hero, Jack would now use it to listen to his activities. The hero is later informed by his sister that their mother is trapped within Bargate Prison under Jack. With this information, the hero goes to save her. The hero travels to Bargate Prison to save his mother, but is stopped by Jack on their way out. Now, Jack had two heroes from the ancient bloodline. For a year, the guards and Jack attempt to gather the information, but they remain silent. After a long year, the hero manages to escape with his mother. Although managing to escape, Maze learns of the old abbey in Hutt Coast and manages to kidnap Teresa and uses her bloodline to perform a ritual. With this complete, Jack acquires the Septimal Key and begins the next part of the ritual by activating the focus sites scattered throughout Albion. With all of the focus sites activated, Jack successfully attacks the Heroes Guild and enters the Chamber of Fate. Now with the Sword of Aeons in his reach, he kills a recaptured Scarlet in front of her son, her connection to the ancient bloodline being the final piece needed to give the sword its power. After all of these years of waiting, planning, manipulation and murder, Jack finally reclaims his sword. After an epic battle, the Hero of Oakvale defeats him just minutes after receiving his sword. The destruction of his body creates a vortex, and with this, Jack's soul escapes the mask, and so he survives again. Over the next year, Jack looks for a new host to possess and finds himself within Archon's Folly in the Northern Wastes. Here, he is able to take the form of a dragon. From here, Jack uses his abilities to bind summoners to Albion, where they attack for him past the Bronze Gate. Past the gate, William Black, now going by the name of Scythe, attempts to stop the evil Jack conjures. With fear and unrest in the Northern Wastes due to Jack's antics, the Hero of Oakvale travels north and, using Jack's old mask, he acquires souls to unlock the mechanism locking the Bronze Gate. As the Hero steps inside, he discovers the new form of Jack and they battle once again. As with his previous battles with members of this bloodline, Jack is defeated and with this, the Hero uses the mask to absorb his soul. Here, Jack is at the Hero's mercy, his last chance to convince the Hero to wear the mask which would give him more power, but he would lose his free will in the process. With this decision, it is said that the Hero threw the mask containing Jack's soul into the fires of the region, destroying the mask and with this, Jack's soul. Although believed to be dead by many, Jack's name still appears through the land. Some say that Jack took over the small village of Oddwood, while others believe that Jack goes by a new name and uses a glamour to appear as a regular human. Even by the Age of Enlightenment, 500 years later, the Cult of Blades still worships Jack as a god, branding themselves with a tattoo in honor of him, waiting for his return. Jack had escaped death multiple times through trickery. So maybe, just maybe, there could be a small chance that he is out there somewhere. What do you think, Hero? Hello Heroes, thank you for watching this lore episode on Jack of Blades. I'd just like to thank my gold tier patrons. Jonas, Mathias Croqvist, Scruffshroom, Sheev Palpatine, ZeroXP Podcast, Sarklantrophy, and Lewis. Your support helps me make these videos. As always, like, share, and subscribe if you found this interesting. Now, enjoy your day. Bye.